Welcome to another demonstration of the CMIzapper Medusa. In this video, I'll show you that we can read the ROM out of a motherboard. I have two boards here, which both have been bought off AliExpress, and they have millions of components missing. This one has a hole drilled in it. The second one has an even bigger hole drilled in it. We'll be trying to read the ROM from these, and we'll see how it goes. Maybe it works, maybe it doesn't. It depends where they drilled the hole and what is shorted out and what is not. We use a little easy flash adapter that comes with the Medusa. Plug it into our cable, and we plug the cable into the speed connector or mat connector. People also call it a JTAG connector, but there's no JTAG on there. Okay, we plugged it in. It sees what kind of ROM chip it is, so that's hopeful. Ah, and it can find the VSS block, the FSIS block where your serial number is stored. Yeah, and the Mac is set to English. Location services are turned on. Even shows you the last network this dead Mac was connected to before it died and went to China and Apple tried to fix it and couldn't. Ah, the keyboard is set to Spanish. Name of the computer. Serial number of the computer. Production date, 2015. Makes sense for this model. It's not locked. Firmware, so it's a MacBook Pro 11.4. The ME version. It is actually also possible to use the Medusa to clear the ME region. And that was it. It will just loop around. Let's try and copy the ROM. Who knows if that works. We put one switch up and it's reading mode. Again, it tells us that it sees the chip. Now it's going to erase the internal ROM of the Medusa. This takes a little while, so I'll fast forward it for you guys. Almost done erasing. And it's reading. I'll show you that the Medusa is clever and that it can see that there is a Mac it's talking to, or a ROM chip rather. If I disconnect the plug, it will stop reading. See, it stops where it was, and now it's continuously looking if the ROM chip has come back to life again, and when I plug it in. And then it just continues once it has proper contact again. So if it reads the ROM, you know it is actually reading correct data and not some rubbish because the connection is bad. This is the big difference between the Medusa and your normal ROM reader. If you're using an EEPROM programmer to do this, then you will have problems if it doesn't see the ROM all the time. It will not notice and will read all zeros or Fs or some rubbish or another, making your dump of the ROM useless. So that worked very well. Let's verify it just in case. But from the way it works, the verifying is basically pointless because it will always verify. But the option is there, so you don't have to believe me. So it verifies. Theoretically now I could connect the Medusa using the auxiliary plug to a normal programmer and read the ROM from the Medusa into my computer. And do whatever I want with it. Let's try the second motherboard, see if we get lucky again. Board number 2 from the same Chinese supplier. I have to put the switches back to normal reading mode. Now, here we're not being lucky. So it is saying it's reading the MISO pin of the speed bus, which is stuck low. And there is some other mode, which I don't remember where. Oh, here. Yeah. This way we can see if we're actually managing to drive the pins. So, yeah, it is saying we can drive the chip select pin, we can drive the clock pin, we can drive the MOSI pin. So those are not shorted anywhere. But the input pin, the MISO, is always low. And it's not wanting to talk to it. So something is wrong with this board. It's obviously shorting somewhere. Which must be on the power supply pin, because the chip select, the clock, and the MOSI are being driven.